freed from the burden of gravity. Freed from the burden of gravity. Should we not dance? Not only in body, but also in the mind. Freed from the burden of gravity, should we not dance? Not only in the body, but also in the mind. Gratitude from the forsaken wings, from the drop feathers of a night heron, and stones that are morphed in the iron cold. Melted the red sun's aura into the hands that painted the hearts on the cave walls of Lasor. You may think about palimpsest in your off-grammatology class, but I didn't intend to steal those daffodils in the market square. Trading for sunlight and rain, even when the receding shorelines erupted no cause for the printed catalogues that you display in the honor of Bauhaus or Filmneuer, walking in the gypsy drapes or with the eagle jewelry of the decades that remained to be spoken about. As girls with jasmine flowers tucked into their curls, and some violets and Marrakesh perfume, the damask rose that once plucked by the hand were blessed by Avalokiteshvara, by the Cherokee, by the hidden tribes of an ancient land. Walking a long mile in Milwaukee, those shattered windows and broken legs and hornpipes and broken carriages, lamps and beanbags are left to be eaten by the serpent of time. After wandering on the pages of the railroad tracks of abandoned steel that goes nowhere to meet, lost in the forests, where the stars unfold the red giants in the holy sepulchre of the holy hooks and bridge, among cedar and pine and redwoods. There is a sterile thunder in between leaves, they awaken to the dawn. When the clouds sweep in a fast gaze, grazing the willows and the lost river, an aeolian harp that plays a note for the nine muses, trading the lines that she sang in the years to come. They might take back those unsung melodies that are trapped in our brain, in the pocket notebooks of Dylan or Johnny Mitchell. As the wind struck the ringing bell, over and above, in the dunes of Jaisalmer, they will fetch the water from the well, drops of dew left by angels in the thorny thistle that camels chew. Left by Hermes and Aditya for the paupers and kings. A song of autolycus, a tale that only Diogenes knew before he buried himself in the sea sand with his lantern hanging out and the wagging tail of a dog who followed him to heavens. A tale that only Diogenes knew before he buried himself in the sea sand with his lantern hanging out and the wagging tail of a dog who followed him to heavens. Freed from the burden of gravity, should we not dance? Body, but also in the mind. Little by little, the night time is around. The leaves which tremble at dawn. Lotus lean on each other in yearning. Over the hills, a swallow is resting. Controls for the heart of the sun. Set the controls for the heart of the sun.